Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you a day in my life during anchor. First, let me tell you what an anchor is. An anchor is a metal object which is used to connect the ship to the seabed to prevent the ship from drifting away due to the wind or the current. A ship might be anchored for two reasons. One reason is for the pilot to arrive and take the ship into the port. Another reason is simply because there are no berths available in the port, so the ship has to wait for loading or discharging the cargo until a suitable berth is available. Anchoring is usually not done in the middle of the sea. A ship can only be anchored at a place designated by the port. A lot of ships can be anchored close to each other at a safe distance, and the anchor duration may vary from a few hours to many days depending on the port schedule. These are red and green channel markers which are called buoys. These buoys usually drift on the water and guide the ships to safely pass between them to reach the port. We are in the Brazilian waters now, and these waters are quite popular for pink-nosed dolphins. These are called Amazon River dolphins, and the color of the dolphin is due to the clarity of the water in which they live. The darker the color of the water, the pinker the dolphins will be. Basically, if there is a lot of sunlight passing through the water, then the dolphin loses its pink color and they turn gray. Certain species of these dolphins are also called albino dolphins, and they are very rare to find. The dolphin calves belonging to these species are usually born dark gray in color, and later they turn pink if there is lack of sunlight. Such a pleasant sight to see these dolphins jumping around with a lot of freedom. This is a huge container ship anchored right next to our ship, and you can also see other ships anchored at a safe distance. We are at anchor for almost 8 days and rescue boat maintenance is being carried out. This can be done any time before reaching the port, either during sailing or at anchor. The rescue boat is usually started, lowered onto the sea and checked for its working condition. This maintenance should be done compulsorily from time to time, though we do not use the rescue boat on a daily basis. We use this boat only during emergencies. It's almost 4 o'clock in the evening and we are celebrating a birthday party tonight, so the chef is quickly making some soup and dinner. This is a garlic mushroom soup. This soup tastes really good and I thought I'll cover this recipe for you guys. For those who are interested in watching this recipe, you can continue watching this video. You can try out this recipe at home. But if you're not interested in cooking, you can forward the video to 8 minutes and 53 seconds where the birthday celebration begins. As for the soup, start by adding some oil to a pan and add grated pieces of garlic. Once the garlic turns brown, add 4 to 5 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. Saute it well until the flour crumbles and the raw smell of the flour leaves the pan. Now add some water according to your desire and bring the pan back to the stove. Make sure the flour gets dissolved well in the water. We do not want to have any lumps in our soup. As for the masala, the chef is adding some salt, pepper and some soup masala cubes. These soup masala cubes were available abroad, but in India we get such masala cubes in Maggi. So you can buy such cubes and add it to your soup for extra added flavor. If you don't like to add any ready-made masalas, you can just skip it and go with salt and pepper alone. He is also making some rava halwa simultaneously. To a pan, he has added some oil and ghee in equal quantities, and then he has added some cashews and grapes. When the nuts are getting roasted, add about 3 cups of rava and roast it in the oil. Now the rava will start to crumble. Mix it well until it turns soft. This might take about 4 to 5 minutes to combine together and get cooked. At this point, we can start adding our sugar. You can add sugar according to your taste and mix it together until all the sugar dissolves and combines together. Right next to this pan, you can see a big pot in which about 25 liters of milk is boiling. This milk will be boiled and cooled down to make curd out of it. This curd will be kept in the fridge for 5 days and once it's over, new batch of curd will be made. Once the sugar has completely dissolved, add double the quantity of water to this rava. The rava will absorb all the water and it will start to cook. While the chef is preparing dinner, the GS is busy cleaning the entire galley. When we reach the port, health inspectors, food safety inspectors, coast guard inspectors and a lot of other inspectors visit our ship. They even check if there's any dirt that's accumulated in the corners. They check if there's any kind of insect or ants present in the galley. So it's important to wash the galley with hot water and soap from time to time and keep it clean. If you have been watching my videos continuously, you would have known that we've been sailing for almost 35 to 40 days and we've been having frequent parties on board. Due to this reason, we ran out of many party supplies, party foods and even cake batters. So the chef had to make a cake today with very limited ingredients and his own recipe. We did not have any ready-made cake batters in hand. Now the rava halwa is almost ready, let's keep it aside and we'll go back to our mushroom soup. We haven't added the mushrooms yet because the flour has to cook completely before adding the mushrooms. Mushrooms are very soft and tender and it only requires a few minutes to get cooked. Today we are going to use ready-made mushrooms which are available in cans. They are already prepped and cleaned. There goes the last step, adding chopped mushrooms, boiling it for some time and when it's cooked, removing it from the hot plate. That's it guys, our mushroom soup is ready now. It's 7 PM and we are all set to party. That's it for this video, guys. Hope you enjoyed watching it. When we are at anchor for many days, the mood is kind of relaxed and the work is comparatively less. But we'll be arriving at the port very soon and everyone on ship will start working like mad and crazy. There won't be any party until we leave the port. If you enjoyed this video, give a thumbs up and stay tuned to our channel. Meet you next time in another interesting video. Take care. Bye-bye.